You don't agree?
Or because if that is the case, then where is the question of all this at all? If it is has to happen, it happens.
Is this, all this means what?
Huh?
What is
the question? You know, the introspection, to get into the root.
When the introspection has to happen, it will happen. Not one day up earlier, not 2 days earlier. Exactly at the precisely appointed time, it will happen.
No, but that's a very frustrating and helpless situation. Because frankly...
So, it is a frustrating, helpless situation when you understand the helplessness. But so far your life has been very joyful. You are living, every day you are jumping with joy. Then there is something wrong with your understanding of life, no?
No, sir. Just that one point that you are saying, that everything is happening because it is meant to happen.
Hmm.
And you have no control over...
I didn't say who is you.
Okay, yeah.
I have not come to that you.
Yeah.
I have not understood the I also, you also. Okay? Huh?
I mean, okay, this is okay, but... Thing is that it is not happening to me also.
The me also will understood. I have not understood. There is no, it is a thought. I am just explaining you the mechanism of the thought and the body. I have not defined what is I. I have not defined whether this control is there or not. I am just pointing out the body and mind, there is no control. It's just happening.
Yeah.
I didn't say you don't have control or you are not control. I don't say that. I am saying body is a machine, is operating. Is there a doubt about that? I am saying mind is generating thoughts. Is there a doubt about that? Madam, when you say awareness has to happen, that's a thought. Okay, that appeared to you at the right point of time. Then it started going into awareness. Okay. Listen to my words carefully. Sri Ramana Maharshi says, there is no free will for you. What will for you means body and mind.
There is no
free will.
Free will.
This is for body and mind. When I say you, body and mind, okay? I use the sense you and I in different connotations. Whatever has to happen, will happen, is happening. This is Ramana Maharshi's teaching, okay? I am not putting my words. If I put my words, I may corrupt something, okay?
Free will. That's called free will.
Everything is predestined.
Predestined.
Everything is a script. You are just executing the script. You means body mind complex. Program. Okay? Then one newspaper reporter was sitting there. He just switched on the light, fan. He said, is this also predetermined? Major events, okay. Marriage and divorce and all these things are predetermined. Is this? Yes. I am telling you why it is yes. Because you don't know the mechanism of thought operating, you don't know the mechanism of body operating, still you believe that you are thinking and operating the body. Is it removing your freedom? Which never was. Okay, the moment you understand, this body, mind, intellect mechanism is not me, it's a machine, you will not feel bad. You are feeling bad because you are thinking that you are a body mind mechanism. Still, the thought is there. Understand? Okay.
So when it comes to a question of thinking, doing, and all that, we feel very freedom. But when it comes to something that is when you are experiencing pain and all that, that comes as a very.
So next sentence of Ramana Maharshi. Next sentence. The first sentence is everything is predetermined. Okay? Next sentence of Ramana Maharshi is you have a choice.
they look contradictory.
When I say you, you have to understand what is you.
Yeah.
Okay? you have a choice to identify body, mind, and intellect, or you have a choice to identify consciousness. The moment you identify the consciousness, you will feel, experience peace. The moment you identify the body-mind complex, which is a machine, your turmoil will increase in life. That's the only choice you have. You don't have a choice of doing or result of that. You don't have a choice of thinking or result of thinking. Madam, too heavy?
No, I'm contemplating.
So you said it's on program, right? Who is the programmer?
That you'll find out. First you find out you. First you find out you. Right? When you ask somebody who, that's again a concept. First of all, you are a concept for yourself. Right? One drunkard asking a question, why the road is running? First you have to get down your, what is it?
Alcohol level.
Right? Then and also I'll tell you, in this question, in this thing, I'm not giving you answers. I'm just pointing out as reality as taught by Vedanta and ancient sages like Ramana Maharshi. That is my mirror, that's the reflection. The reflection is what you are seeing now. I am not giving any answer of my own. You have to discover the answer of your own. That's what I'm saying. That choice will appear to you if you are designed for that. Why in half a million people are not sitting here? One rock star concept, half a million people will come. Only 10 people are there, that hardly. Why? Anybody has a disagreement with this thing? I have not told any, imposed my any views. Okay, I have just showed you logically. This all jnana. You may agree or disagree. But have I shown anything, put my own views on that, belief systems on you? So, the moment you understand everything is happening, you will feel relaxed. There is no place for guilt. There is no place for suffering, because suffering has to happen, it will happen. For the body-mind complex, which is a machine. So how many people have cried when washing machines become old? Huh? You have to pay the money, is okay. Washing machine is crying, how much work you are putting, are you crying? Huh? Does anybody care?
If I wash
your clothes, I'm saying, washing machine says complaints. Every day you are putting in so much work. Do you care? Your car says, why are you using my bike? Says, how many kilometers I am running? Give me some rest. It's a machine. Okay. But you start crying the moment you say you are that washing machine or you are the bike. You identify with that. Yes or no? It's just a machine. What is it supposed to do? It's supposed to do. And you don't like washing machine doing a cleaning job or washing machine driving your car. It's exactly doing what it's supposed to do. Now you have some question. No? No? Is it too? See, what I am doing is I am addressing the basic structure of your consciousness, which you never will not by yourself you will not be able to do. Okay, I am debugging your consciousness. I have a user manual for debugging consciousness, it's called Vedanta. And I'm not saying this is wrong or this is right with you. This I'm saying this is where the problem, this is where the issues are. Just address that. Look at that. And entire my learning I have put in a board here. Okay, you can go there. When you get up, you can see. 10 sentences, 10 lines are there. They're all the ultimate teachings of Vedanta. That's all is used to debug human life. Okay? So, please understand, do you have guilt in your life? Do you have guilt in your life?
But I'm not that.
So, whatever has happened. At that moment, it happened. As per the will of a higher power, which I don't know, I call it as God or consciousness, God's will. Do you have anxiety what will happen to me tomorrow? However hard you try, however hard you think, what has to happen will happen. Does it mean that I will keep quiet? If you are supposed to do some action will happen.
I think quiet is also
not in our hand.
No, silly point is also not in your hand. Action has to happen, then action has to happen. No, no, all this I understood. Whatever has happened, you sit here. What happened? Let's see. You can't sit. Half an hour, you start getting up. I have to go home. That thought will come. No, no, this has to be done. That thought will come. Whatever instructions and programming I used in the program, that will be done. That's why it's kind of said, sages said, thy will be done, not my will. There are no two wills. You think that's your will and God's will. Huh? In a house, wife's will and husband's will is there, is it?
Only
wife will is there. How can there be two wills, you tell me, anywhere? So you have an illusion that I have thy will and my will. Only thy will. And husband will say, it's my will. As per the instructions.
Boss with my wife's.
This is the reality of life.
This is knowledge plus experience, so it's
resonating.
Very easily digestible.
Please understand, there is no two will. There's only one will. Thy will. So what is my relation to thy will? Find out.
That's why you should accept the wise will also.
That's why
the wise will should be accepted.
See, you're the authority. Okay? So, please understand, the human beings, whatever you call us beings, are the dream characters produced in a dream called Maya. In your dream, you met so many people. Did they have free will?
No, they have also been controlled.
But you think they are free will? You have talked to them, interact with them. But I say people, it's a bodies. This exactly situation, this situation is what you call Maya. These are the bodies which have been produced, which will act accordingly as if there's a free will. Madam? ಏನು ಹೆವಿ ಆಯ್ತೋ ಅಥವಾ ಇಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಯೂ ಯೋಚನೆ
ಮಾಡ್ತಾ
ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹೆವಿ ಫಾರ್ ಟುಡೇ ಹೌ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೀ ವಿಲ್ ಮೆಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಮಂತ್ ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಯು ನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಹಾಂ ಸಿ ದಿ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ದಿ ಡಿವೈನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ರಿಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ Okay, so Ramana Maharshi said that, okay, yes, you have heard of this guy called Stephen Hawkins? Hmm? He has written a book called Everything is Predetermined. Everything is predetermined by written by a scientist or a spiritual, right? Everything is predetermined by Stephen Hawkins. He says why everything is predetermined. It's like a book. The story is written, but you as a body-mind mechanism will read one page a day and execute. So he says everything is predetermined, but as far as we are concerned, it's useless because I can read only one page a day. I can't read what is the end story, I can't read what is the... Got it? Madam? Okay. So that's what is my Maya. Everything is appearing to be having free will, but really no free will. Everything appears to be real. Why it's not real, we'll come to that, okay? That's another level. There are dimensions. Otherwise, 9 months classes are there. So many levels are there.
So suffering is by us or body mind?
Who is us? Who is body mind? You tell me. Who is us?
Suffering is by being.
You tell me. I don't give you answer. You tell me.
Body. It is the body.
Body, there's no suffering. Body, there's a pain.
Pain.
Okay. Suffering is for the mind, which means ego.
Ego, yes.
Okay. Ego suffers because ego thinks it's free will. It says I have action, I have something can be done. Okay, when the results are not coming as per the will, it starts crying.
Pain?
Pain for the body. It's a part of the nature.
Physical.
Pain is physiological.
I feel pain.
Huh?
I feel
pain. That's what I mean. I feel pain. Feeling is for the mind. I is consciousness.
So I think myself as mind.
Who is that I think myself as mind? The ego. Are you the ego? You have to tell.
But when suffering or pain comes, it's very much real that pain.
What is reality? We'll have to understand, okay? Yesterday night, I am sure you went to a hotel and ate jalebi. And somebody kicked you. That was painful. Is it real?
At that moment.
This also like that. At this moment, this is real. Mm-hmm. Okay? Moment, reality, what you call as reality is moment to moment. Let us understand the ego and thoughts in bit more detail, but I can't do jam pack your system too much. Okay, right now I give only appetizer. Okay, the dish is yet to be served. So please understand the lessons of today. Everything, whatever we see, experience, feeling is a happening. Okay. That I call as God's will. It doesn't stop us from doing anything, because you have to do something, that also will happen according to God's will. But knowing this will reduce our
stress.
Suffering.
Stress.
Okay. You understand?
Yeah.
So I'll give it for it. One example is you have a always a feeling that this guy could have done something better, different in the career. He has not done it. He has done exactly what is required to be done. And what will have to be done will happen as exactly. Neither you have a choice nor he has a choice. The same thing applies to you also. But please understand, the moment you start understanding this, this peace sets in. This is actually what is meant by surrender. Okay? Surrender is not removing the problems. Surrender is accepting life as it is. We don't want life as it is. We with ego. The thought process. Okay? Understand? Now why are you coming to this class here?
You don't have any choice.
You don't have a choice. And this guy, ego, has to be debugged something higher than ego. That debugging is happening here. Ego itself cannot debug. Body itself cannot debug itself. So something, a higher consciousness based on teachings is trying to help you debug, get rid of this suffering. So the highest teaching is said in Bhagavad Gita, the conclusive, Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Raja Aham Dvam Sarva Papebhyo Mokshishyami Mashuchaha. What does it mean? Sarva Dharman. Dharma means body, mind, intellect. Each has some dharma. Body has some dharma, mind has some dharma, intellect has dharma. Parityajya means understand that it's acting according to nature. Mamekam sharanam raja means what? Surrender to me. Who is the me? Krishna, the consciousness. Understand? Consciousness in you, or consciousness not in you, the consciousness. Surrender to that. Then what will happen? Aham tam sarva papebhyo mokshishyami. All sins are forgiven. What is your sin? Tell me.
Wrong identity.
Huh?
Identification.
Suffering. What is suffering? I should have done this. I should not have done this. What will happen to me? What will not happen? Okay? Right? Why I am like this? I should be something like this. That fellow is better than me. I am worse than him. comparison, jealousy, anger, hatred. Everything will disappear the moment you understand everything is happening according to God's will. You have only to surrender to consciousness, not to the body mind. Now you have surrendered to body and mind. Understood? Madam, clear? Your doubt? Why I am not getting enlightened? Madam, why didn't you discover the E is equal to MC square?
It had to be done by that person.
Not that person.
By that.
That body, mind, intellect
combination.
Combination. Otherwise, Nobel Prize, madam. Why are you missing it? Why are you teaching here in this college? Huh? You should be on the world stadium. Madam, why are you sitting here? You should be preaching enlightenment to all millions of people. Sir, why are you not in a very top flying, high flying job? Why are you taking a break? Why you have married that fellow? Please understand, you have not done anything. These are all things happening. Okay? The moment you do that, it's called surrender. Sharanagati. That's why three acharyas are there. Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya, Shankaracharya. Okay? Ramanujacharya said, highest spiritual practice is surrender. Over. Finished. Nothing else is done. Shankaracharya said, highest spiritual practice is jnana. So now I am doing, understand, now I am doing 2-in-1. They both mean same thing. Madhvacharya said, highest spiritual practice is bhakti. So what I am telling you? Surrender to God, bhakti. So whatever three acharyas teaching, I have told you in one class. In the way you can understand, in the way at least I have understood. Are you clear? So there is no need to for us to get tensed up or worried or feel anxious or guilty. Everything is happening according to God's will, according to consciousness. So my choice is either I tune to consciousness or tune to the body mind complex. That's all the choice. Okay, the more you tune to consciousness, you'll feel peaceful. The more you tune to the body and mind, you'll feel restless. Who is the you? I'm referring to ego. Clear? Shall we stop for the day? Just let us meditate for 5 minutes. 5 minutes. We eat up too much time in the debugging.